Hello dear students, welcome to the YouTube channel of Konar Classes. Today we are going to discuss about combinations. Already we discussed about permutations, okay? Now with the help of that permutations we will derive the formula for combinations, okay? So let us understand by means of an example. Okay, suppose there is a lawn tennis club in which there are three players X, Y, and Z. Okay, so there are three players X, Y, and Z. And what is the purpose? Purpose is that to form a team. Okay. Consisting two players, selection, correct? We discussed in one of our previous session that combination related to selection. So that means out of these three players we are going to, you know, select two players to form a team. Question is that in how many possible ways we can form that. So for that, what we can do, we can take one is that XY, correct? No, then we can take XZ, and then we can take YZ, correct? Now the moment we took XY, then it doesn't make sense that we can take YX, correct? Because it is selection. We bring X, the player X and player Y, form a team. It doesn't mean that I need to place Y and then X, it's same. So we no need to consider that YX. Similarly, we no need to consider ZX, and we need to, no need to consider ZY. Why we no need to consider? Because this YX represent the same as XY, ZX represent the same as XZ, ZY represent the same as YZ. So that means this we no need to consider, okay? And that will help us to form the, you know, that what is the possible number of selections. One thing we are clear, the possible number of selections is actually three. We see here XY, XZ and YZ, but how we derive it? And that derivation can come from the, you know, permutation formula. Think about that there are three, you know, players, and we need to take two out of them and make an possible arrangement. What is the possible form? What is the formula? It is 3P2. And what is 3P2? It is 3 factorial divided by 3 minus 2 factorial. So that is equal to 3 factorial by 1 factorial. 3 factorial by 1 factorial. That is equal to 3 into 2, that is 6. Now, so then what are the possible arrangements? XY, XZ, YZ, XYX, ZX and ZY. So out of this, we no need to consider this one, correct or not? So what we see is that YX, ZX and ZY, right? This no need to, we no need to consider, you know, this many. So what we can write then? We can write then is that the possible number of, you know, that arrangements, a possible number of selections what we are getting is that is actually 3. So how we are going to get this 3? So that possible number of arrangements we are getting 3, that if we divide 6 by, you know, 2, because this is actually exactly the same thing, so we divide it by 2. Now divide it by 2, how we can write? We can write is that it is a factorial 2 ways. So what we can write? The possible thing is that 3P2, the possible number of selection, 3P2 divided by 2 factorial. Okay, so now if we find this thing, so that is equal to 6. 3P2 is 6, we already found it out, and 2 factorial is 2, that is equal to 3. So now let's make these things a problem that a little, you know, bigger. So let's take, there are, you know, 3 letters A, B and C. Okay, let's take 3 letters A, B and C, and A, B and C. Now, if we need to, you know, make an arrangement by taking two at a time, what are the possible number of arrangements? I'm not talking about combination. What are the possible number of arrangements? The possible number of arrangements are AB, then BA, then AC, CA, then BC, then CB. Correct? So now, this is the possible number of arrangements. But for possible number of selection, we consider AB and BA together, we consider only this one. AC and CA, we can consider this one. BC and CB, we can consider this one. This is not required. These all are not required as long as the combination is concerned. So what are the possible number of combinations? It is actually the 3. Correct? Well understood? So what we see is that here comes the the combination. Out of n objects, out of n objects, okay, out of n objects, the possible number of selections, possible number of selection of R objects, okay, is denoted by, how to denote it, is denoted by NCR. In case of permutation, we denoted it by NPR. Because of permutation, we took the letter P. In case of combination, we take the letter C, NCR. And what is this NCR? One thing we understood by means of this example, that NCR is equal to nothing but NPR divided by R factorial. As we see here, okay, that BA, CA and CB, that is 2 factorial, is actually wiped off. Correct or not? Now let's take another example, okay? Instead of taking that, 2 objects, let us take all the 3. Okay, let us take all the 3. Then what are the possible number? We get A, B, C, A, C, B, okay, B, A, C, B, C, A, okay, C, A, B, C, B, A, okay. So what are the possible number of arrangement? It is actually 6. Now, you think that the interesting part is that suppose there are 3 in a club, there are 3 team members. And if we need to form a team members considering all the 3, what is that possible number of selection? Only 1, no? ABC. Their order doesn't make sense as long as the selection is concerned. So that means what? So this entire number, these 6 numbers, is actually, which is the possible number of permutations, is actually converging, reduced to the way you want to define, to a only single selection, that is ABC. So what is the value of N here? The value of N is 3. And what is the value of R? That is also 3. So then what is the possible number of permutations? NPR, what is that value? That is 3P3. That is equal to 3 factorial divided by 3 minus 3 factorial. That is equal to 3 factorial. That is equal to 6. Now, the moment it is a selection, so all these combinations, so how many combinations, how many arrangements? There all 6 arrangements are actually clubbed to 1. That means this NPR has to be divided by R factorial. That means 3P3 has to be divided by 3 factorial to get the value of the possible number of selection. So what is the possible number of selection? NC3 NCN, NCR, in this case it is actually 3C3. That is equal to what? That is equal to 3P3 divided by 3 factorial. Always remember, whatever is there R, NCR should be equal to NPR divided by R factorial. What I wrote here? NCR is equal to NPR divided by R factorial. Okay? Now, what happens is that what is 3P3? 3P3 is equal to what? 6. And what is factorial 3? Factorial 3 is equal to also 6, that is equal to 1. And it is obvious, right? Suppose in a lawn tennis club, there are 3 players, A, B, C, and we need to form a team considering all the 3 players. So how many ways we can form the team? Only one, A, B, C together. Their order doesn't make sense. It is not arrangement. If it is an arrangement, then it is a different, you know, question. Correct? So we get that NCR is equal to NPR by factorial R. Now let's look into it. What is that? So let me rub it off and let's look into it more details. Now what is NPR? Okay, NPR, when you say it, is that taking that R objects from the N distinct objects. Okay, so now in this case what happens, the value of R, you know, when you take objects, is that the value of R is greater than 0. That means it has to be 1 and it has to be at least 1 and it has to be less than equal to n. Correct now? So now let's look into that, what is that NCR then? NCR, what we see it from here, we get NCR is equal to NPR is equal to what? N factorial divided by N minus R factorial and divided by R factorial. So that means what you can write, this is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Correct? So N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. That is the formula for NCR. Now, let's take another case when R is equal to 0. What is the meaning of R equal to 0 and NCR? NCR, okay, when R equal to 0. So this formula we have established when R is greater than 0 but less than equal to n. But what happens when it is R equal to 0? Think about, there are n distinct objects and you are not taking any objects. In how many ways you can make that selection possible? That is quite obvious. It is 1, whatever is left out. Correct? So what we see is that when R equal to 0, that is equal to is 1. That means what? This implies that NC0 is equal to 1. NC0 equal to 1, and that we can fit into this formula as well. How you know, dear students? That is equal to, 1 is equal to, we can write N factorial divided by 0 factorial into N minus 0 factorial. Correct? Because n factorial, the 0 factorial is 1, we know, and n minus 0 factorial is actually n factorial, that will get cancelled, will get 1. So now, when R equal to 0, the value of NCR is equal to, we get into the same form as n factorial by R factorial into n minus R factorial. So what we can say by clubbing it together, we can say is that NCR is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Okay, when 0 less than equal to R less than equal to N. And I hope you understood it. If you do not understand it very clearly, please write it in the comment section. Okay, and I will again try and explain you. Okay, now let's see some interesting part. So let me write it here, okay? And let me use a different color, okay? So what we see, dear students, we see that value of NCR is equal to n factorial divided by r factorial into n minus r factorial. So how to do this thing? Remember it. NCR. So in the numerator you should write n factorial. In the denominator you should write r factorial. Whatever there is r, that r factorial into that n minus r factorial. Okay, so that means you should subtract r from n and we get n minus r factorial. Let me give you an example. Suppose we need to find the value of 7c2. What is the 7c2? That is equal to, first we'll write 7 factorial, what is there in the numerator, divided by 2 factorial, okay, into 7 minus 2 factorial. That we should subtract 2 from 7 and 7 minus 2 factorial. That means what? That means 7 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 5 factorial. Correct, dear students? Fine. So that means what is 7c2? Let me give you an example. Suppose there are 7, you know, chocolates are there. Of 7 chocolates are there, different chocolates, different color, a wrapper, and I want to take 2 chocolates out of it. In how many ways I can select? That is, you know, 7c2. Or examples, or there are 7 different colors balls are there, okay, and I need to take 2 out of that. In how many ways I can take? It is 7c2. Okay, let's take this example. There are 7 different colors balls, tennis balls are there. Okay, out of those 7 balls, I need to take 2 balls at a time. In how many ways I can make the selection? That is 7c2. Remember, we will find something interesting after a few minutes. Now, dear students, let's come to the, you know, analytical part and let's find the value of NCN minus R. What will be the value of NCN minus R, dear students? So it will be, in the numerator it will be the same n factorial, correct? Denominator it should be n minus r factorial, the way we have done it. So in the denominator it should be n minus r factorial into, what we should do? We should subtract n minus r from n. So what we will get? We will get n minus r factorial, correct or not? Okay, I repeat, whatever is there, n, c, n minus r, first it is, let me explain it here, n, c, n minus r, first it is n factorial divided by whatever is there is this n minus r, that is n minus r factorial, into that n minus r should be subtracted from n, that means n minus r factorial. Let's see it here, n, c, r, n factorial divided by whatever is there in this r, that is r factorial, into that r has to be subtracted from n, that is n minus r factorial. 7c2, 7 factorial, in the numerator, denominator it is 2 factorial, and into 7 minus 2 factorial, that is 7 factorial by 2 factorial into 5 factorial. Now let's see it here, let's observe. So this is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into n minus r, that means n minus n plus r, let me write it down, this is equal to n minus n plus r factorial, correct? So now what we see it here is that n and minus n will get cancelled, then what we are going to get? We are going to get n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial, which is nothing but the formula for NCR. So what we get? NCN minus r is equal to NCR. What does it mean? Let's come back to the example of that 7 different color tennis balls, and from those tennis balls we need to take, you know, 5 balls at a time. In how many ways you can make the selection? So that means it should be 7c5. What is 7c5? 7c5 is equal to 7 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 7 minus 5 factorial. So that is equal to 7 factorial divided by 5 factorial into 7 minus 5 is 2 factorial. And it is exactly the same as 7C2. So what does it mean? Out of those 7 different colors tennis balls, the number of ways we can select 2 balls is equal to the number of ways we can select 5 balls. Very interesting. So that means, and from where we get NCR is equal to NCN minus R. So let me write it down. This is a very important observation, that is NCR is equal to NCN minus R. Very important observation. Okay. And when we study about binomial theorem, we will see that application of this particular thing is there in very much. So what we understood, suppose there are, you know, there are in a club, there are 10, club members. Now you need to make a committee consisting 3 members. The number of ways you can make a committee consisting 3 members is equal to the number of ways of making a committee of 7 members. Why? Because 10C3 is equal to 10C7. Okay? What I wanted to mean is that, suppose there are in a club, there are, let me rub it off here, okay? So so there are 10 members in a club. And what is your task? Your task is to form a team, form a committee consisting 3 members. In how many ways you can do? That you can do it in 10C3 ways. So what is the value of 10C3? From our understanding, it is 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 10 minus 3 factorial, that is 7 factorial. Now that is equal to the number of ways we can form a committee by selecting 7 members. So that is equal to 10C7. That is equal to 10 factorial divided by 7 factorial into 10 minus 7 factorial, that is 3 factorial. Okay. So I hope you get a very clear idea about what is meant by combination, that from n distinct objects, number of possible ways of selection of 3 objects. With this note, I would like to conclude the session for today. In the next session, we will solve some problems related to combinations. And till that time, please provide your comments, writing in the comment section, and do let me know how you feel about my lectures. In case you want to know some different topics, please do let me know and I will provide accordingly. My plan is to complete the entire class 11 and class 12 topics, completely provide in YouTube sequentially. So your assistance is required to provide comments so that I can make your understanding appropriate in that manner. Thank you very much.